Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. Today we will talk about Dow Jones. The Dow is up 60 points today. Ever heard of something like that on the news? But what does it mean? The official name of Dow Jones or Dow 30 is the Dow Jones Industrial Average. It's a stock market index that tracks the performance of 30 large and famous companies in America. Dow Jones was first created by financial journalist Charles Dow and his business partner Edward Jones in 1896. They saw that many or most stocks tend to move like a wave in the same direction from day to day as the investor reacted to events and expectations. They wanted to put a number on that daily movement and create a simple tool for tracking how the US economy was doing. They combined the 12 biggest industrial companies' stock price into one statistic and created the Dow Jones Industrial Average. These companies were the leader in their own area, including the railroad, gas, sugar, tobacco, and oil industry. At the close of every trading day, they added up all their stock price and divided by 12. That was the Dow Jones Industrial Average. In the earlier 20th century, industrial companies' performance was typically tied to the overall growth rate in the economy. As a result, the relationship between the Dow's performance and that of the economy was cemented. Over time, the index improved it, and as of 2020, the Dow includes 30 companies from 9 different sectors. The 30 companies in the Dow are selected because they are considered as the market leader in their own area. Apple, Microsoft, Disney, Coca-Cola, and Nike are all the cases in point.
So now let us talk about how we can actually use the Dow Jones Industrial Index to determine which company would be the most prospective one for a person to invest in the right way. First, you put all the stock numbers closed each day for all 30 companies contained in Dow Jones of recent years in an Excel sheet like this. So after you have sorted out all the stock numbers for companies in Dow Jones, you can start to calculate the daily rate of return. To do this, you type in equal LN, which means stock number of one day slash stock number of the last. Take this Nike one as an example. To calculate the daily return on June 11, 2018, you type in equal LN, which is B4 slash B3. In this case, Nike has about negative 0.0041 for its daily rate of return. Pretty straightforward, right?
You can then calculate the excess returns using equals parentheses daily return divided by 365 times number of the year. After you finish the calculations and drag down the bar to get all the data, you can start to figure out the standard deviation which determines the risks. A higher standard deviation means higher risks. To calculate it, you type in equals STDEV parentheses all the daily returns for a company. STDEV stands for standard deviation. Then you just drag the bar to the right to get all the company's standard deviations. To get the standard deviations for excess returns, you type in equals STDEV all the excess returns for a company. At this point, you are prepared to calculate the Sharpe ratio. The Sharpe ratio measures an investment's performance compared to a risk-free asset after adjusting for its risks. The higher the Sharpe ratio, the better your opportunities to invest in that company. If you get a negative Sharpe ratio, it means that the risk-free rate is higher than the portfolio's return, or that the portfolio return is negative. To calculate the company's Sharpe ratio, use the mean excess returns divided by standard deviation of excess returns. These are the 5 companies I calculated from 2018 to 2020 that had the best Sharpe ratio. If you consider investing, focusing on these 5 companies in the Dow Jones will be a wise option.
In general, the Dow Jones Industrial Index is a reliable source that evaluates the economy since it has included 30 most influential conglomerates in the United States. All of the Dow Jones indexes reflect the whole market, and meanwhile signal the economic trends nationwide in a mutual measure. Thus, if one of the Dow Jones index suddenly deviates from its own direction, the potential fluctuations or even weaknesses in the general market are implied, which facilitates it to serve as an alert for the public. Moreover, it functions as the benchmarks for the companies. When it comes to the individuals, especially the investors, the Dow Jones is an effective indication for the current stock market, which allows people to speculate the future economic trends.
But this is not it. There are still many other ways to analyze stocks and the Dow to make sensible investment decisions. And now, let us end our conversation with a movie clip from The Wolf of Wall Street that shows how Leonardo DiCaprio was able to sell his stocks.
Hello, John. How are you doing today? You mailed in my company a postcard a few weeks back requesting information on penny stocks that had huge upside potential with very little downside risk. Does that ring a bell?
Oh, yeah, I may have said so.
Okay, great. Well, reason for the call today, John, is something just came across my desk, John. It is perhaps the best thing I've seen in the last 6 months. If you have 60 seconds, I'd like to share the idea with you. You got a minute? Name of the company, Aerotine International. It is a cutting-edge, high-tech firm out of the Midwest awaiting imminent patent approval on a next generation of radar detectors that have both huge military and civilian applications. Now, right now, John, the stock trades over the counter at 10 cents a share. And by the way, John, our analyst indicator could go a heck of a lot higher than that. Your profit on a mere $6,000 investment would be upwards of $60,000.
Jesus, that's my mortgage, man.
Exactly, you could pay off your mortgage.
This stock will pay off my house.
John, one thing I can promise you, even in this market, is that I never ask my clients to judge me on my winners. I ask them to judge me on my losers because I have so few. And in the case of Aerotine, based on every technical factor out there, John, we are looking at a grand slam home run.
Okay, let's do it. I'll do $4,000.
$4,000, that'd be 40,000 shares, John. Let me lock in that trade right now and get back to you with my secretary with an exact confirmation. Sound good, John?
Yeah, sounds good.
Great. Hey, John, thank you for your vote of confidence, and welcome to the Investor Center.
Yeah, thanks a lot, man. Thanks.
Bye-bye.
How'd you do that?
Just like that, I made $2,000. The other guys looked.
Dow Jones Industrial Average is a 30-stock price-weighted index that measures the performance of the largest U.S. companies. This means it includes a list of 30 large-cap companies selected by the average committee. In most cases, the stock market performs well when the large companies do well, allowing Dow to reflect the market. A stock is added only if the company has an excellent reputation, demonstrates sustained growth, and is of interest to a large number of investors. The committee will also make replacements if companies in the components underperform the overall market. In fact, components have changed 57 times since its inception. In 2018, General Electric, the last remaining original company in Dow, was replaced by Walgreens Boots Alliance. But Dow is now perfect. The 30 companies included in Dow are way inadequate to present the entire stock market, which contains thousands of companies. In rare cases, Dow fails to represent the market. The S&P 500 instead would be more accurate because it includes 500 companies.